Scorchio, that beautiful weather out there, what you have all been waiting for, so you can go around town in your summer dresses and your shorts, it's playing havoc with me in here. I got here at 11 o'clock yesterday and the sun was up there. And this white stuff here, it's called Monoflex. Scaffolders use it to sort of encapsulate a building with scaffold, yeah, and weatherproof it. Now, at certain times of the year, at certain intensities, it will diffuse that light to a point where, yeah, you're perfectly fine to be glassing under it, putting top coat on. This sun is that intense out there now. It's ridiculous. And it wasn't just from like 11-ish for an hour when I got here. It's been since first thing this morning, pretty much. And I'm glassing this morning from the window here, just out of shot, all the way around to where I started yesterday. I've made the lines that nice, I can't even see them myself. Right, I joined up to this point here. So, what effect is this sunlight having? Well, it was to the point where I had to ask the customer to come back from work to help Jerry rig something else up, because it was like a greenhouse in it, and it is still really warm. So, while the customer was at work, I found that black sheet. I thought, well, that's going to have to go up as a thing, see how the temperature responds in here if we put that up and keep it away. Can you see how it's away from not being dropped down vertically? Yeah? It's away. Black being black absorbs heat, doesn't it? It's absorbing the heat, and that heat is radiating in here. So I'll take you outside in a second and show you what else we've done to try and counter this strong sunlight getting in. My head's all in a mush at the moment. I don't mind admitting it. I've got my Aldi special telling me one thing, and I've got my other one telling me another thing, temperature wise on these walls. Boom, let's go. What we got here? 23.9 on the green one and 20 on the right hand side one. So I've got a difference of 4 degrees. What's my head meant to believe? A difference of 4 degrees again. 4 degrees difference again. What's going on? What have I told you for years? This is not a 100-mile-an-hour rush for me to get out of this pond and back up to Derby as fast as I possibly can. So what am I going to do? First off, I'm going to tell you about this light. Remember I did a little video on that light, thumbnail as a lightsaber, yeah? Let me give you an idea. This light getting through the diffuser and the heat getting through that Monoflex is casting enough light in there for me to be able to see the denibbing process, which is this. Now, truth be known, that's more of a muscle memory exercise, because you don't need, I've got to have 50,000 kelvins of light to be able to do that, because I've just done it and it's successful, yeah? But, if we handle that round, and put that on, look at the difference that's made. Now I can look at that from this sort of distance, yeah, and I'm like, yes, I know there are no pinholes in it because I paddle rolled it properly. I've got tons of resin on it properly, yeah, but what a bonus to be able to see in such new detail, yeah? It did help me detect just a little bit of a nib in the tissue down there that I overlooked. So yeah, this light Is it a game changing bit of kit? I don't know about a game changer, but you know what? It's certainly very useful. And don't forget, this is middle of June. Strong sunlight out there, which we're trying our best to block out, being the glass's enemy. On my eye, I certainly don't like it anyway. For elevating temperatures of this up, making top coat go off even faster than it already goes off. Imagine a job later in the year, September, October, when it's not intense sunlight. This really is going to come into its own as an essential tool for me, because we're going to be blocking the light out with covers, yeah, on jobs. So we need to reintroduce some light, don't we, to aid our vision with. So yeah, beautiful. I'm satisfied now that this is all denibbed. Let me just go and show you these covers actually. So, customer started off with this Monoflex with the intention of diffusing the sunlight coming through, turned it into a greenhouse. And then we went for that black sheet, which is angled downwards and away, because the heat on the back of your hand on that thing with the sun bearing down it is ridiculous. Now we've put a third tarpaulin up. We've hopefully that silver reflective affair going on to bounce that sun, which is up like a halo, doesn't it? Bounce that sun back to where it came from. Oh God, this is better. This is better in here. So, like I said, I'm not in 100 mile an hour. I'm not in a 100 mile an hour rush to get on that dual carriageway motorway back up to Derby, especially at the expense of this top coat going off on me or going off in the bucket wasting here. Just want this to turn out nice. So, rather than trust any of those that are giving me different readings, let's just check again. 3 degrees difference again. 3 and 4 degree difference. Which one do you trust? I'm going to go with my instincts. I'm going to wait for that sun to go round, because we've blocked the sun getting in at that angle. Now the sun's coming round at that angle. It's just a rigmarole to be keep shifting that cover, the reflective one, all the way around, yeah? Risking falling off a ladder. Just gonna be patient, just let that sun go round. I'm here for the day. I'm either in the pond or on the motorway. It's job priority, that's what I call it, job priority. Everything's gone well so far. Don't want to let it down at this point or at any point. So yeah, that's what's going on in my world. What are you lot up to today? This is so good. That is so good. Right, let's have a so sweep down, get rid of the worst of the dust that was created during the denib. Then that will be allowed to settle. For a few seconds, while I'm doing this. You can see all my All my tools for the last few years have been cordless. I need a cordless mobile portable lamp with that kind of light output. Any ideas? Roger, I'm sure you'll find me one. Gareth, I'll just explain this in the video, even though I've already explained it to you in person. The customer came out this morning when I was still in the van, and they had a little feel of the fiberglass. And I said, well, look, let's just do that little bit of prep work that I do to it, and then come and have another feel of it. So he described it as a little bit, very slight, wispy, stubbly. I sanded it down, gave him a little demo reception there, and invited him to do it again. And his words were, perfectly smooth. His words, not mine. Is it perfect smooth? That word perfect, it's incredibly smooth. Be even smoother with the top coat on. But I do not promise perfection. So I'm basically getting all this dust up. Look. Doesn't take long. Few seconds of work to do this. This will be done again and again if necessary. Just so this video doesn't appear as me just waffling on while I'm waiting for that sun to go around, have a look at the dust that that little operation has just generated. Don't want my customers having to sand all that down in a couple of days. All that. That's what I'm here for. And then we get the vacuum out. Get that drum. Get that drum to right into the corners. These little, how long was that with the vacuum cleaner? 30 seconds, sanding, 15 minutes. All this is intended for minimizing the input of the customer. 48 hours a week later, whatever, in checking it. Done a video on post top coat checks. Arms behind your back so you're not tempted to rub at it with your fingers or your hand, as if an insect or a fly has rolled around in the top coat. When it's wet, it dries rock hard and it'll open your hand up. There is nothing. Let's have a look down that wall. This is after my visual checks and just going over it with the paper here. There ain't nothing, and I mean nothing, gonna hurt a fish when the top coat goes on to that. But sod's law, despite all being covered up like this, we're still working outside. Roller fibers, which I try and minimize as much as I possibly can, they can get into that top coat. It's a fact of life, it's unavoidable. I was saying to the customer earlier how I've, for reasons, stayed over on a couple of jobs and de-nibbed the jobs myself because I didn't want to drive home from a job on a Friday night. I've stayed over an extra night in the van, come into the top coated pond that was done Friday afternoon, Friday evening when the temperature got great. Came in and checked the top coat, arms down my back, not rubbing at it with my hands. Nothing to do on that wall. Nothing to do on that wall. Oh look, something's got in it over there. Oh dear. End of the world. And then just literally, whatever that was that contaminated it, just denibbed it. It took seconds of work to do it. So all these little bits of prep add up to minimal customer input later down that line when it comes to, you know, hopefully all the customer should, in the ideal world, all the customer would have to do, bond the window in and then put their dome on the bottom drain. Reality is fiberglass reality, yeah. I'm not dressing this up as bathroom tile flat, not far from it, but you know, I'm not dressing it up as bathroom tile flat, yeah. You're putting a wet liquid on. Things can contaminate it, unfortunately. It grinds away at me, it kills me that it happens, but it does. So, enough chit chat. Like I say, Gareth, I am extremely conscientious on these matters. I want you to have as little input as possible. You spent a lot of time on this pond yourself, a lot of money on this pond, and it's down to me to get this fiberglass for you as nice as I can for you, you know, given all of the variables that are involved in doing this. Yeah. Happy with it so far, just going to exercise a little bit of patience, as I would with every customer.